And we got a mulligan on our hands. If I had one more land, this hand would be excellent, but I think this is too risky to keep. Well, if I had one more land, this hand would be excellent, but given that we're at 6, I kind of have to keep. Funny how that goes. Not super happy with the Glimmer Void, because there's no guarantee that it will live, but at least I have enough cheap cards that can well, stick around, hopefully. Do I want to dismember the Noble Hierarch? I don't think so. I think I'd rather just go for the Vault Scourge, keep dismember for kind of a bigger threat, given that I'm kind of lacking in lands and not gonna get out of the gates all that quickly. I might not need the tempo play of killing the Noble Hierarch instead, because I'm gonna be rather slow, assuming that I don't draw a land right away. This game might take a bit longer, in which case I wanted to keep the dismember for something more relevant. Unfortunately, it is a Stony Silence time, which means that I hate my life. Well, Mox Opal doesn't do anything anymore. Otherwise, we could have been playing the Cranial Plating. I guess I might as well play it to protect the Glimmer Void or something. And I think I still don't want to play the Dismember for kind of the same reason. I'd rather kill a bigger dude while, well, attacking with Vault Scourge is kind of the plan. Maybe draw some Nexuses and then Edge Champion. Cranial Plating doesn't have any abilities anymore either. What? Okay, so if I want to play Dismember, I have to play it right now. Or wait until I draw a Glimmer Void, a Blink Mod Nexus, or an Ink Mod Nexus. That might still be a while. I mean, obviously, most of my mana producers, Dark Soul Citadel, Mox Opal, Springleaf Drum, don't work anymore. And giving him the Noble Hierarch, just with Exalted and maybe mana production, can give him quite a benefit as well. So I think I'll just play it right now. Not happy about it, far from it. But at least maybe he has some non-creature spells in hand as well. Hopefully the Talia is gonna harm my opponent just as much as me. And preventing even one damage per turn could be useful if we get into a Vault Scourge fueled damage race. So Ink Mod Nexus, it's a good start. Playing the Cranial Plating is not really gonna do much, but I'm also not gonna block with the Ink Mod Nexus. And wait, what? I'm just casting this Cranial Plating. Oh, never mind. It obviously costs one more mana through the Talia. I was thinking I was somehow locked out with Stony Silence. Never mind. Well, as I said, whether or not I have the Cranial Plating in play doesn't really matter too much. Only for something like Master of Ethereum. So, not the end of the world. Wildleaf Leech, sure. I mean, that is kind of a type of card that I was saving my Dismember for. If I knew that I had Ink Mod Nexus on top of my deck, I would have held on to it. Dark Soul Citadel is a complete and utter blank. Yeah, seems unlikely that I will be able to win at this game at this point. Maybe if I draw Inkmot or Blinkmot Nexus and then play Edge Champion on the next turn, I can start blocking his guys while still having a 14 turn clock. But scavenging ooze also makes things more difficult. Well, whatever. Stony Silence got me once again. So having learned a bit more about my opponent's deck, well, I'm not impressed. I think if I draw a reasonable and he doesn't have Stony Silence, then I can easily win. Whipflare wasn't all that good because I just saw the Wildleaf Leech that's gonna protect his guys. Master of Ethereum is probably gonna be better. And yeah, apart from that, I just have to hope to dodge Stony Silence.